Good morning everyone. I am Dr. Malathi, Department of Biology in GSI PU College. Welcome to this session. I am dealing with chapter number 5, that is nothing but inheritance of variations and theory. So in the last sessions or previous sessions, we already studied few important points, that is monohybrid cross, dihybrid cross, and incomplete dominance and some of the technical terms. Now coming to the next very important topic, that is chromosomal theory of inheritance. It was proposed by Walter Sutton and Theodore Boveri in 1902. Before entering into this chromosomal theory of inheritance, you need to understand some of the important points why this Mendel's work was not recognized till 1900. Why Mendel's work was not recognized till 1900? Mendel started his work in 1856 and he published his work in 1865. Unfortunately, Mendel's work remained unrecognized till 1900 because of some of the reasons. Some reasons are, during that time what happens, there will be a communication, it not so easy. That is the first point. And then coming to the second is, factors do not show any blending. So that means if the two genes are brought together on a hybrid, they separate during the formation of gametes. So there is no blending character. So first is important one is the during that time the communication was not so easy. Second is Mendel's character or the factor or the traits or the genes do not show any blending. He was the first person to introduce mathematical logics and statistical analysis for the experiment. And these three characters are the three important points. Mendel's work was remained unrecognized in 1900. In 1900, three scientists, Hugo de Varis, Karl Correns, Erich van Schamark, rediscovered Mendel's theory. So in 1900, three scientists, Hugo de Varis, Karl Correns, Erich van Schamark, rediscovered Mendel's theory. At the same time here, in 1900, due to the improvement or the advancement in the discovery of the microscope, some of the scientists observed that there are number of changes takes place in the cell division, and they observed that inside the nucleus there will be a presence of some of the structures, and these structures are said to be, what do you call, chromosomes. In 1900, due to the advancement or the improvement in the discovery of microscope, some of the scientists observed that there is a presence of chromosomes or the structures that is present inside the cell, and how there will be a division takes place, and how, what are all the changes that takes place during cell division. In 1902, scientist named called Sutton, in 1902, Sutton, he was an American scientist. He was working on grasshopper, and he observed that the chromosomes occurs in pairs like this. and these chromosomes occurs in pairs, and then during meiosis they get separated so that there will be a formation of gametes. So according to Sutan, chromosomes occurs in pair. So in the pair we can see one in the pair, one chromosome from the father and one chromosome from the mother, and during meiosis they segregate or separates during the formation of gametes, so that the chromosomes occurs in pairs and they separate during the formation of gametes. This explains the theory of Mendelism. Around the same time, Boveri, Theodor Boveri from the German, he was working with sea urchin, so that later this Sutan and Boveri theory combined together to form what we call as chromosomal theory. According to this theory, or this theory states that there is a presence of genes particular position on the chromosome, and the pattern of behavior, or the how these genes or the chromosomes that are inherited from one generation to another generation, that explains the Mendel's law, and also how and why the genes are inherited from one generation to another generation. Here this chromosomal theory shows a parallel line between the Mendel's work. There are three important points. This is the chromosomal theory and this is the Mendel's work. According to this theory, chromosomal theory, chromosome occurs in pairs. Today what we call it as homologous chromosomes. According to Mendel, here genes or the factors occurs in pairs. This is the first point. Coming to the second one, if the chromosomes occurs in pairs, they segregate during the formation of gametes during meiosis. Here also the alleles segregate, that results in the formation of gametes. This is nothing but law of segregation. Now coming to the third point, if there is a presence of more than one chromosome or the different chromosome, here they segregate independently during the formation of gametes during meiosis. Here also the same thing, more than one gene present in a hybrid, what happens? They independently segregates or separates during the formation of gametes. So these three important aspects, that is the chromosome occurs in pairs and the chromosome segregate during the formation of gametes, and then more than one chromosome, what happens? That also separates independently during the formation of gametes. So coming to the next is, according to this chromosomal theory of inheritance, here what happens, they observe, Boveri and Sutan observe the movement of chromosomes, movement of chromosomes. Here this is meiosis 1 of anaphase, this is the meiosis 2 of anaphase. We already studied in the first year, there are two types of division. The one is said to be mitosis, that is the equational division. Meiosis, that is nothing but reduction division. So during meiosis, what happens? Here meiosis 1 of anaphase, you can see here the chromosomes are separate or move towards the opposite poles without the division of centromere. That is the first point. So chromosomes or the homologous chromosome move towards the different opposite poles without the division of centromere. But in case of meiosis 2 of anaphase, now look here, there will be a movement of chromatids towards the pole with the division of centromere, so that from the one individual cell or the parental cell, there will be a formation of four daughter cells, that is nothing but germ cells. Understood? This is how the chromosomal theory. So chromosomal theory, according to this theory, the genes are present on the chromosome, and these chromosomes, how these chromosomes are moved during the cell division, that is nothing but meiosis 1 and meiosis 2. And in the meiosis 1 of anaphase, what happens here, the homologous chromosome move towards the poles with the division of, sorry, without the division of centromere. Here in case of meiosis 2 of anaphase, what happens, there will be a movement of chromatids with the division of centromere, so that finally results in four daughter cells. So that this theory give evidence to the Mendel's work, so that the genes are present on the chromosome and the genes are considered as a unit of heredity. So now, later what happens, few years later, another scientist called Morgan, in 1933, he did some experiment in fruit fly, that is nothing but Drosophila melanogaster. He was selected Drosophila melanogaster because these Drosophila melanogaster can be cultivated in the laboratory, that is in the synthetic media, and the single mating can produce large number of progeny. And then these two characters, based on these two aspects, Morgan carried out some of the experiment, and this Morgan proved that Sutton and Boveri theory of chromosomal inheritance. So according to this chromosomal theory of inheritance, the first point is the genes that is present on the chromosome, so that how these chromosomes behaves during cell division. So here what happens, in the meiosis 1 and 2, what happens, there will be a movement of chromosomes in opposite direction, so that results in the development of, from the one cell, there will be a development of four daughter cells. This is about the chromosomal theory of inheritance. Next, we move on to multiple alleles. In the previous session, we already studied alleles, contrasting characters. So, multiple allele, gene exists in more than one form, therefore it is said to be multiple. Gene exists in more than one form, then it is said to be multiple allele. The best example is blood groups in human beings. What is meant by blood? Blood is a fluid connective tissue. It contains two parts. The one is said to be cells, and the second one, without the cells, the liquid part, is said to be plasma. So there are three types of cells here: RBC, WBC, and platelets. RBC, erythrocytes; WBC, leukocytes; platelets, thrombocytes. So here what happens, in the RBC, generally RBC is like this. Here the plasma membrane, this is the plasma membrane. Here the plasma membrane has some type of a sugar substance. Here there is a presence of some type of sugar substance. So here what happens, here there are four types of blood groups. Four types of blood groups: A, B, AB, and O, together is said to be ABO blood group, and ABO blood group is controlled by the gene that is denoted by letter I, that is nothing but isoagglutinogen, another name for antigen. So how many types of blood groups are there? There are four types of blood groups: A, B, AB and O. And here it is denoted by letter I, that is nothing but isoagglutinogen. So here blood group A that contains IA, blood group B that contains IB, blood group AB that contains IA and IB, and blood group O, there is an absence of these antigens, so it is denoted by small i. So that this I, isoagglutinogen, it is nothing but I, has a three types of alleles. The one is said to be IA, second one is an IB, last one is IO, or the small letter I. So isoagglutinogen or antigen that has three types of alleles, IA, IB, IO. So here human beings are diploid in nature, so that every person possesses only two out of these three. It may be IA, IB or IA small I, IB like this, or maybe II. So that here both this IA and IB, there is a slight variation in the sugar component, whereas this small I do not produce any type of sugar. So this is about the basic concept. Now coming to the blood groups. So blood group, there are four types of blood groups. Blood group A, the here there is a presence of IA, 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 or this is homozygous, or maybe IA small I, or it may be heterozygous. Blood group B, IB, IB, that is homozygous, or it may be heterozygous, IB and small I. Blood group A, there is a presence of IA and IB. Here what happens, in the blood group A, if this is homozygous condition and this is heterozygous, so in this case what happens, only this IA exhibits or expresses. Here also only IB that expresses. But in this case what happens, in the blood group AB, there is a presence of both IA and IB, both are equally expressed. Therefore this is called codominance. Both are equally expressed. Therefore it is said to be codominance. In the blood group O, there is an absence of antigen, so that it is denoted by small I and small I. This is about the genotype of the parents. Now we have to do one cross, so that how it enters into or pass on from one generation to another generation. Here the parents are blood group A is crossed with the blood group B. In the genotype, you have to take only the heterozygous condition, because if we are taking heterozygous condition, we will get more number of offsprings. So IA small I in cross with IB small I. Coming to the crossing, this one is crossed with this IA and IB. Next, this one with this IA and small I. This one with this IB small I, this one with this small I small I. Now you have to identify the offsprings. This is both IA, IB is there, both are equally dominant, therefore It is said to be codominant, therefore the blood group is AB. Here only this one is expressed, so the blood group is A. Here only B is expressed, therefore the blood group is B. Here there is no antigen, therefore the blood group is said to be O. This is about the multiple alleles. Gene exists in more than one form. Next is very simple one, pleiotropy. Single gene expresses many characters. So the single gene expresses many characters. The best example is in Drosophila, the vestigial wings for, or the gene responsible for the vestigial wing, that is also responsible for the development of number of X. So vestigial and the small anta. Particular gene is responsible, only one gene is responsible for many characters. So that a single gene is responsible for the development of vestigial wings, and the same gene is also responsible for the development of or the synthesis of number of X. So pleiotropy means single gene that expresses many characters. Coming to the last one, polygenes. Here, as the name itself indicates, many genes responsible for single character. Best example is skin color in human beings. So nammalli iruvanta skin color is the best example for polygenes, so that many genes are responsible for the single character. For example, here Negro is crossed with Coscozoid. Negro andre eno, kappagiro antaru dominant character. So that is denoted by A, big A, big B, and small big C and big C, because it is dominant. Coscozoid andre melanin pigment is very less, thumba fair agirtare. Those are said to be Coscozoid. So that is recessive character, small a, small b, small c, small c. So if the Negro is crossed with the Coscozoid, Negro is said to be dominant and the Coscozoid is said to be recessive. In the generation, there will be a first generation, there will be a formation of mixing of these two. Big a, small b, big C, small c. And this is said to be mulattoes. Mulattoes, intermediate color. So if a mulattoes marry another mulatto, what happens in the next generation? There will be a development of varieties of shades. Maybe dark irbodu, negro irbodu, Coscozoid irbodu, mulattoes irbodu, light brown, dark brown, etc. So these are all nothing but the best example for this polygenes. Many genes that exhibit single character. Best example is the skin color in human being. Negro, dark color complexion, is said to be dominant, and the Coscozoid completely fair. That means completely there is an absence of melanin pigment, that is said to be Coscozoid, and it is said to be recessive. If these two are crossed in the first generation, there will be a formation of intermediate character here, that is mixing of these two characters, that is said to be mulattoes. If the mulattoes marries another mulatto, what happens? There will be a different varieties of shades. That is nothing but the best example for polygenes. So in this session, I hope you understood some of the important points in the chromosomal theory of inheritance, and why the Mendel's work was remain unrecognized till 1900 due to some of the reasons. And after that, Boveri and Sutan, these two scientists combined their work to form a theory that is said to be, what do you call? That is the chromosomal theory of inheritance. They observe that the genes present on the chromosome and the pattern of inheritance of these, or the movement of these chromosomes during meiosis, that explains the Mendel's theory. So And then this Mendel's or the chromosomal theory of inheritance always gives a parallel line with the Mendel's theory, so that there are three important points, so that the chromosomes occurs in pairs and these are segregate during the formation of gametes, and then more than one chromosome also that independently separate during the formation of gametes, and how these chromosomes behaves in this condition we already studied with comparative study of the two possibilities, possibilities 1 and a possibility 2, and so that here the anaphase 1, the homologous chromosomes, what happens, move towards the opposite poles without the division of centromere. And in the next division, that is the anaphase 2, what happens? The chromatids move towards the opposite poles with the division of what? Centromere. So totally results in 4 haploid gametes. That is nothing but 4 daughter cells. Thank you.